Hello children, hope you all are doing well. Today I am here with a video for the students of class 5. In this video, I will teach you chapter 4 from your EVS book, that is Our Dependency on Animals. In this video, we will go through following topics. The first one, our dependency on animals. Second one, uses of animals. Third, animals for livelihood. Fourth, cruelty towards animals. Fifth, animals in danger. Sixth, wildlife conservation. And the last but not the least, Project Tiger. So let's begin with the very first topic, that is our dependency on animals. Children, human beings depends on animals for different things, for different purpose. Earlier, human killed animals to obtain food, but later on, they learned to domesticate animals to obtain food, to obtain different products as well as services. Animals also relieve people from hard labor or heavy field work. Now children, you might be wondering, what all services and goods do we get from animals? So, be patient children, it will be clear to you through my next topic, that is uses of animals. As I have mentioned earlier, animals are very useful for humans. The reason is because they get varieties of goods and services from them. Here are a few points which shows usefulness of animals. First one is, leather is obtained from skin of animals and used to make different products. Children, you might have seen your parents using bag, belt, shoes, wallet, etc. All these things are made from leather, and leather is obtained from skin of various animals. Animals like goat, cow, giraffe, lion, etc. Silk thread is made from silkworms. Silk is used to make clothes like saris, dupattas, kurtas, etc. The process of rearing silkworms to obtain silk is called sericulture. Children, for obtaining silk, cocoons are collected and then cocoons are boiled out to separate silk fiber from it. Coming on next use, wool is obtained from fur of different animals. Like you can clearly see in the picture, fur of sheep, goat, camel, yak, etc. are used to make wool. And then this wool fiber is used to make woolen clothes, woolen wears that we use in winter season to protect ourselves from cold. Children, wool is a natural animal fiber, and all these animals have outer covering of hairs, which is shaved off to obtain wool fiber, and then we make woolen clothes out of it. Now moving towards next use of animal, bones and teeth of few animals like tiger, rhinoceros, deer, elephants, etc. are used to make ornaments and decoratives. Product made by elephant tusk, that is the long outer teeth of elephant, is called ivory products. Means the product which is made from the long outer teeth of elephant or the tusk of elephant is called ivory product. Children, actually today ivory products has been restricted as people are deliberately killing elephants for it. But still somewhere animals are killed or the animals are hunted for their bones and teeth for making decoratives and ornaments out of it. Some animals are domesticated to obtain
goods like milk, egg, meat, etc. Animals like cow, buffalo, camel, goat, etc. give us milk. There are some other animals, children, like hen, goat, fish, etc. give us meat. Whereas animals like hen and duck gives us eggs.
Children, these all are the product that we get from the animals. But some other animals like horse, donkey, yak, etc. are used as means of transportation also for carrying people and their goods from one place to another place. Children, I think you might have understood that animals are used by human beings in different ways. And we are dependent on animals for various purposes, for the things, for food, for services as well. Now moving towards my next topic, that is animals used to earn livelihood. Livelihood means, children, to earn money. Many people, not only in India but all over the world, depends on animal for their livelihood, children. Animals like horse, donkeys, ponies, elephants, yaks, camels, etc. They are different animals which are used for as a means of transportation, children. And they carry people as well as their goods from one place to another. This already I have discussed in our previous topic also, that animals are used as a means of transportation. So yes, they are used to earn livelihood, means they are used to earn money also, children.
Monkey is used by a madari to show dance and tricks. So children, there are some people, those who train monkeys, and they are known as madaris. These madaris used to train monkeys to show dance and trick to people in order to entertain them, and in return people used to give money. And then they collect all this money, and this is how they earn their livelihood. There are some other people also, those who used to train bears. They used to remove nails and teeth of the bear's cub while training them so that they may not harm them, they may not bite them. This is how they use bear to entertain public, to entertain people, and they again earn money by entertaining people, children.
Now coming on next set of people, that is farmers. Oxen are used by farmers to plow their field, and this is the reason why oxen are known as farmers' friend. Now coming on snake charmers. So children, snake charmers are the people, those who use snakes to entertain public by playing a flute. Children, snake charmer does so by removing the poison sac and the teeth of the snakes. And then they play the flute, and as they play the flute, children, snakes swears to the tune. Swears means they used to move. They show different types of body movement. As they sense the vibration of the flute, they sense the vibration of the tune, they used to show some bodily movement. And at that time, it seems like they are dancing. So this is how people get entertained by the snake charmers, and they used to give money to them. And this is how they earn their livelihood. Now coming on Gujjars. People who rear cattle are called Gujjars. They rear cattle for their products. Products like milk, butter, ghee, curd, etc. As you can see in the picture, there are some milk products given. Gujjars used to rear cattle, and they earn money by selling these products. Other than these animals, parrots and elephants are also used to earn livelihood by different people. Parrots are used by fortune tellers, and elephants are used by mahouts. From above mentioned points, you might have understood that we humans are dependent on animals in many ways. People who depend on animals take care of them.
And if they fall sick, they give them proper care and takes them to the vet. Vet means the animal's doctor for their proper treatment. They give them good food to eat and they take care of their shelter as well. Means they keep their shelter clean. And also children, these people consider these animals as their member of their family. Now moving towards next topic, that is cruelty towards animals. Cruelty towards animal means to mistreat animals for their services without giving them proper food or rest, or to kill animals for their food, skin, teeth, bones, etc. For example, animals like cows, buffaloes, horses, etc. are whipped cruelly by their masters to get their work done.
Animals of a circus or a zoo are often kept in dirty cage and not fed with proper food and water. Such places like circus and zoo are like a prison for such animals. Now coming on the next point, that is pack animals are often overloaded with goods. Pack animals means the animals which are used for carrying goods. Pack animals are often overloaded with goods. Through the picture, it may be witnessed to you children how animals are treated cruelly. To treat animals cruelly is an anti-human practice. It should be avoided. Now moving towards my next topic, that is animals in danger. Children, in my previous explanation, I have already mentioned there are some people, those who use animals' skin, fur, tusk and bone for different purpose to make different things out of it. This is the reason why people are hunting animals. Other than this reason, there are some people, those who hunt animals as a sport also. This has greatly reduced animals' population. Means there is a great downfall in the number of animals, due to which animals are on verge of extinction. In the right hand side, you may see some pictures. Some pictures of animals are there. These animals are extinct animals. Children, extinction means the total disappearance of animals from the planet. Means such animals were existing earlier, but now they are no more on earth. Therefore, they are considered as extinct animal. Few examples and is mentioned is given in the picture, that is mammoth is there, golden toad is there, quagga is there, etc. These are some extinct animals. These animals used to exist on earth, but now they are no more. So children, now I hope what extinction means is clear to you. So the animals, those who are on verge of extinction, are known as endangered animals. So in order to protect animals from extinction, government has banned hunting. But still, there are some people, those who are indulging illegal hunting. And this is known as poaching. Poaching of animals. Poaching is an illegal offense.
Now moving on to the next topic, that is wildlife conservation. Government has banned hunting in India and has set up many wildlife reserves and sanctuaries. These wildlife reserves and sanctuaries are the place which provide natural habitat to wild animals to live there safely. Such wildlife reserves and sanctuaries are made to protect life, wildlife. There are people who work hard to save endangered animals. Such people are known as conservationists. Time to time, various necessary steps are taken up by the government and non-government organizations to conserve wildlife. Now, moving on the next topic, that is Project Tiger, which was established in the year 1973 in order to protect tiger from getting extinct. As tigers are facing great threat of extinction, as tigers are killed for sport or for their body part. In the year 1900, we had about 40,000 wild Royal Bengal tiger. But today, we have less than 3,200 tigers. Seeing this downfall in tiger's population, government has established this project. This project was started with 9 tiger reserves, and at present we have 27 tiger reserves in India. Due to the establishment of tiger reserve, the population of tiger in our country has increased significantly. I hope now I have covered all the topics given in the chapter, children. Now moving on few points which you need to remember. These points I have taken from your book. You have to go through it. These are some important points from the lesson. Now coming on the exercise part. In the exercise, you have 5 questions. Coming on question number A, that is take the correct option. First question is, the tusk of an elephant is called. The correct answer is A, ivory. Out of 3 options, I will be reading out only the correct answers, children. You have to put a tick mark on the correct answers. So for the first question, option A is correct answer. Now coming on question number 2. Madari earn their livelihood by. Correct answer is option C, taming monkeys or bear. Question number 3. Which of the following is an endangered animal? Option C, rhinoceros is the correct answer. Coming on question number 4. Project Tiger was started in the year. Option B, 1973 is the correct answer. Coming on question number B, that is fill in the blanks. The first point is, some oysters have dash in them. Answer is pearl, P-E-A-R-L, pearl in them. Point number 2, animal wastage, bird droppings and fish wastage are used as dash. Answer is fertilizers, F-E-R-T-I-L-I-S-E-R-S, fertilizers. Point number 3. The snake charmers remove the dash and the dash of the snakes. Answer is fangs. F-A-N-G-S, fangs. And the second answer is poison glands. P-O-I-S-O-N, poison. G-L-A-N-D-S, glands. Poison glands. Point number 4. Illegal hunting is called dash. Answer is poaching. P-O-A-C-H-I-N-G, poaching. Point number 5. The total disappearance of an animal species from the planet is called. Answer is extinction. E-X-T-I-N-C-T-I-O-N. E-X-T-I-N-C-T-I-O-N. Extinction. Now coming on question number C. That is answer the following questions. Question number 1. What are the various uses of animals? List any 5. Answer is 5 uses of animals are as follow. First, we get wool from sheep, camel, yak, etc. 2. We get silk from cocoon of silkworms. 3. Animals like cow, goat, camel, etc. give us milk. 4. Animals like duck and hen give us eggs. 5. Skin of some animals is used to make leather products like belt, bag, shoes, etc. Coming on question number 2, how do people use animals for their livelihood? Answer number 2 is, many people use different animals for their livelihood. Some of them are as follow. Point number 1, people like madari, snake charmers, mahouts, fortune tellers, etc. earn money by training animals to entertain people. Point number 2, gujjars domesticate cattle and earn money by selling products like milk, butter, ghee, eggs, etc. Point number 3. Some animals like horses, donkey, elephant and camels are used as means of transport. Now coming on the next question. Question number 3. What do you understand by cruelty towards animal? Answer is, cruelty towards animals means to mistreat animals for their services without giving them proper food or rest, or to kill animals for their food, skin, teeth, bones, etc. Moving to the next question, that is question number 4. Why do people hunt animals? Answer is, People hunt animals for their skin, meat, fur, teeth, bones, etc., which leads them to extinction. Question number 5. Define poaching and extinction. Answer number 5 is poaching. Illegal hunting of animal is called poaching. Extinction, when any species is no longer in existence or totally disappear from the planet, is called extinction of that species. Moving to the next question, that is question number 6. List some endangered animals. Answer number 6 is, list of some endangered animals are as follow. Gorilla, orangutan, white tiger, lion, sea turtle, black buck, Sumatran elephant, musk deer, Tibetan antelope, black rhino, etc. These are the 10 names of endangered animal, children. Now moving on the 7th question. What is being done to conserve wildlife? So answer number 7 is, the government has banned hunting and has set up many wildlife reserves and sanctuaries to protect wildlife. Other than this, many necessary steps are taken up by the government and non-government organizations to conserve wildlife. Now moving on the next question, that is, write true or false. So point number 1, human beings are not dependent on animals. Answer is false, because they are dependent on animals. Point number 2, early humans killed animals for food. Answer is true. Point number 3, ivory products are very expensive. Answer is true. Point number 4, cod liver oil is a source of carbohydrate. Answer is false, because it is a source of vitamin. Coming on question number E, name the animals from which following products are obtained. Children, the name of products are given and you have to write the name of animals. These two work you have to do in your book only. But question number C, that is question and answer, means answer the following question. You will note it down in your copy, children, along with the difficult words. But question number A, B, D and E, you will do it in your book only. So coming on question number E, the first product name is silk. So we get silk from silkworm. Next is honey. We get honey from, answer is honeybee. Third product is ivory. Answer is elephant. Fourth product is meat. Answer is goat. Fifth product is pearl. Answer is oyster. Sixth product is wool. Answer is sheep. Other than sheep, we have some other animals also. So here you can write anyone. Now next one is leather bag. Answer is goat. Skin of animals. So different animals are used. Skin of different animals can be used to make leather. Any one animal name you have to write. Here I have chosen goat to write. Next is milk. Answer is cow. So now children, I have given you answers of all the exercise. Now here is some assignment for you. The first one is, you have to read the lesson. Though I have taught you the lesson, but still you need to go through it. Then only you will understand it in a better way. So you have to go through the lesson. Now when you go through the lesson, you will find some difficult words. Then you have to underline those difficult words and write it down in your EVS copy. And you have to learn those spellings also. Also children, you have to write a message to save wildlife. You have to write a message to save wildlife. This work you have to do in your EVS notebook only. Then complete the exercise given in page number 31 and 32 in your book and write answers in your notebook. Means exercise is given in page number 31 and 32, as means I have shown you that 5 questions are there. Out of that 5 question number A, B and D, E, you have to do it in your book. But question number C, that is answer the following questions, that you'll write it down in your notebook. So I hope everything is clear to you, children. Thanks for watching my video. Stay happy and blessed.